तुझको या तेरे नदीश गिरिवन को नमन करूं मैं, किसको नमन करूं मैं भारत, किसको नमन करूं मैं, नमन करूं मैं, नमन करूं मैं, नमन करूं।
The Supreme Lord has given so much glory to earth that in his divine knowledge given in Atharva Ved, one complete hymn is devoted to earth. It is so said in that hymn that Mata Bhumihi Putro Aham Prithivyaha, meaning I am son of earth and she is my mother. Vishvambara वसुधानी प्रतिष्ठा हिरण्यवक्षा जगतो निवेशनी, मदर अर्थ सपोर्टर एंड सस्टेनर ऑफ ऑल, बेरर ऑफ ऑल प्रॉपर्टी एंड बेरर ऑफ गोल्ड एंड अदर ज्वेल्स ऑन हर चेस्ट, इज द वन हु शेल्टर्स ऑल लिविंग थिंग्स मूवेबल एंड इमूवेबल। बट टुडे अर्थ इज ग्रेवली हर्ट by the arrows of pollution. Greenery is the decoration of earth. Veda has described earth as covered with trees and vegetation. Yastham vriksha vanaspatya dhruvastishthanti vishvaha. Rising temperature has started weakening the fertility power of earth. It has started getting transformed into vegetation-less dry desert where one has to yearn for getting drinking water. The floods and cyclonic winds that can happen due to the battering of volcanic eruptions and earthquakes are likely to translocate millions of tons of fertile soil into the oceans or elsewhere. Because of the inefficient drainage of rainwater, small puddles of water, which grow larger and assumes dangerous proportions, rendering major part of the land useless for agriculture. Bihad of Chambals is an evident example. The many different industrial effluents containing many toxic substances after mixing with water make the land so polluted that it makes the soil infertile. Some of these pollutants in the air, like nitric oxide and sulfur dioxide, come down in the form of acid rains, making the earth acidic and unfit for cultivation. India has 329 million hectares of land as a whole, of which only 266 hectares of land is usable. Of that, 143 million hectares is agricultural and 40 million hectares is fully barren. Remaining 43 million hectares come under forest cover. So, 66% of the land of the country, meaning 175 million hectares of land, is warped.
The remnants left after mining of coal and other minerals render the topsoil unfit for agriculture. Similarly, in those areas where copper is melted, the soil of those areas becomes so polluted that no vegetation can grow. The waste that comes out of houses, industries, and business centers add to the pollution load. Plastic, ash, and iron waste also contribute to the loss of purity of the land.
Cadmium, arsenic, nickel, mercury, chromium, aluminium, and such poisonous heavy metals present in industrial effluents, insecticides, and fertilizers get mixed with the soil, renders it polluted. These poisonous components enter the bodies of animals through plants and water and becomes the cause of many painful diseases. 7,000 metric tons of waste and filth enter the environment in the city of Delhi every day. It is estimated that this could go up to 18,000 metric tons by 2021. Will we try to open our inner vision and listen to this cry of the earth?
पुकार धरती कह रही बात।
My dear sons, even though I am the mother of all movable and immovable creatures of this world in invisible form, I am giving out this clarion call only to you, because you only are superior from the worldly point of view, and you only have the competence to assimilate this. Dear sons, the only difference between me and your biological mother is that she is actually visible to you, but your attention never falls on my motherliness. Your mother feeds you with milk only for a few months, but I arrange for you to get milk from cows and other animals for whole life. Not only that, I also arrange to get you varieties of sweet fruits and grains. From the time of this creation by the Supreme Lord, I arrange to get food for all creatures. It appears that the Supreme Lord manifested His entire nature in my form. Not only the body of your parents, but the bodies of all from the time of the first humans have been designed by me, because the remaining four matter are present within me only in a causal form. I have created many emperors, yogic masters, divinities, and demons. And not only that, after their death, I have accommodated them in my fold. You do not realize my importance even for my namesake. And because of that only, you continue to release your urine and feces. Moreover, you keep spitting all over me and pile up dirt and filth on me. What thankfulness of yours is this? Not only that, you are not satisfied by doing all the above, you also dirty me and water by using poisonous insecticides and fertilizers in agricultural activities. But you don't even realize, while doing this, that the poisonous matter that you are spreading inside me comes back into you in the form of food and make you diseased. Trees and plants are my ornamentation, and through them only I ensure the availability of food to you. What sons are you that by cutting them you shout? What sons are you that by cutting them you shout boisterously that I have denuded you? O sons, what valiance are you showing by derobing your mother? Have you forgotten the contention of Shankaracharya ji?
Kuputro jayate kvachidapi kumata na bhavati.
Meaning, sons can become bad sons, but mother cannot become a bad mother. To keep the dignity of his contention, I cannot show such behavior that you show. You have made me weak and hollow by exploiting me and indiscriminately extracting water, gold, and other such metals, gas and oil, etc., lying hidden in my womb. Because of this activity of yours, if earthquakes happen, why do you hold me responsible? The real culprit is you only. Earthquakes happen only to give you a teaching that don't disown your mother and become so greedy. If you have even a bit of respect for motherhood, I only ask for two things from you as indebtedness. If you can fulfill them, you only will be benefited, as in reality, I am your mother, and by these demands, I want to do greater good to you. Dear sons, the people of all countries are my sons and daughters only. Therefore, I look at all humans equally. The first expectation of mine is that by your technical and other skills, turn the desert like Thar, Sahara, and Gobi that exist in the core of my heart into greenery. If you can do so, my nakedness will be hidden, and when millions of hectares of land become green, you only will reap great benefit. You will become eligible to be called sons of the soil only when you keep the earth pure and clean from the points of view of environment and food productivity. My second demand is that don't kill any creature of the world, as all creatures of the world are my children. When you slaughter millions and millions of my sons and daughters mercilessly within slaughterhouses and spill their blood on me, you only tell me, how long shall I bear your atrocities? Have you forgotten this contention of Gita that
avashyamev bhoktavyam kritam karma shubhashubham?
Humans have to definitely bear the fruits of their good and bad actions. Just as the way you push the innocent creatures into the void of untimely death by slaughtering them, the demon form of Tamogun hidden within you may not become so strong that it would push you into the threshold of a world war. In such a situation, I only have to bear the first pain. You only tell me, how can I see the lifeless bodies of my children strewn over me? You please remember this contention from Gita.
Vidya Vinaya Sampanne ब्राह्मणे गविहस्तिने शुने चैव श्वपाके च पंडिताः समदर्शिनः।
The knowledgeable keeps equanimous sentiments towards Brahmins endowed with knowledge and humility, cows, elephants, dogs, and devils, meaning they see the same consciousness only in all. Don't you know that the same consciousness exists even in the animals that you kill and eat? They also feel the same pain and suffering while dying, just as you feel. When the attributes of Raj and Tam become stronger, people suffer increasingly from the demerits of lust, anger, greed, desire, ego, and such. By the consumption of alcohol and meat, Tamogun finds heightened expression. I have witnessed many wars from the beginning of creation till now. In the previous world wars, I have seen lakhs of people getting killed. I have also witnessed the killing of more than 47 lakhs of people in the great war of Mahabharata that occurred 5,000 years ago. The foundation for this great war was laid by the greed, ego, and crookedness of Shakuni, Dhritarashtra, and Duryodhan. I only want to say this much, that you make your life meaningful by being called divine sons as per the Vedic contention.
Shrinvantu Vishve Amritasya Putrah.
By keeping away from the consumption of alcohol and meat, follow the policy of live and let live. All the creatures other than you are also my sons and daughters. I feel the same sorrow when they die as much as I feel for your death. I hope that you would fulfill my two demands and try to pay back your indebtedness towards your mother.
Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu सुखिना सर्वे संतु निरामया सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःख भाग् भवेत् मा कश्चित् दुःख भाग् भवेत् मा कश्चित् दुःख भाग्।